This bizarre instrument, built by a couple of Yorkshire weavers in 1840, is called a contrabass serpent, also known as an anaconda. It's huge and ungainly, it's a kind of cross between a horn and a reptile, and it makes a not entirely beautiful hooting noise. It never really caught on, but the deep, tremulous sounds it tried to make did, big time. Bass is music's youngest element. It's only been around for four centuries, but since then it's been on an extraordinary journey. The bass line in a piece of music is its foundation, its roots. These days it's an essential component of practically all the music you hear. So this program is about how bass works. This music, made famous by the Stanley Kubrick movie 2001 A Space Odyssey, is by the German composer Richard Strauss, and was actually written in Munich in 1896. One of its most distinguishing features, and one that's been imitated by thousands of science fiction, thriller and horror movie scores, is the long held bass note that begins it. It's awesome, bottom C. It's big, it's deep, and it's powerful. And it came to stand in our minds for a sense of menace, or wonder, or infinity. Just this one note. But there are loads of examples of bass lines that give a piece of music its style and its shape. It's funny to think that there was once a time when composers didn't have at their fingertips the power and depth of a dedicated bass line. But the gradual emergence of bass as a force in its own right is inextricably tied up in Western music with the development of what has been called tonality. Tonality is a catch-all term that describes the whole package of ingredients that make Western music sound different from all the other music in the world. At its heart are keys and chords. To understand bass at its simplest level, we need to know that the most important note in any chord is the tonic, after which the chord is named. C in the chord of C, and so on. Think of the tonic as the center of gravity of a simple chord. The most basic chords have the tonic as the lowest note, and in music, the bottom note of a chord is called the root. And the minute your music has a root, you've given yourself a new job to do, playing the roots. In other words, the independent bass line was born. Playing the roots might sound simple enough, but as bass developed, it was to have a profound impact on all forms of Western music, even determining the shape of the music itself. In the next part, the journey from zero to hero. Around the time that chords, tonality, and roots grew in importance, so did the bass. By the time we get to the Baroque period, the 17th and 18th centuries, the bass line has become so influential that it was often the only thing apart from the tune the composer bothered writing down. Here's the bass line for Jeremiah Clarke's Trumpet Voluntary. Now, those Baroque composers may have elevated the bass line to a position of importance in music, but curiously enough, the one thing they didn't have was a standard instrument to play it on. Even more curiously, the ones they did have weren't very bassy in sound. The one thing you'd expect a bass instrument to be able to do, namely play a very deep sound underpinning all the other instruments, they couldn't. With one magnificent exception. Organs discovered bass, proper, deep, throbbing, muscle-toning, rib-tickling, goosebumps-inducing bass, long before other instruments. Not only that, organs showed that any bass worth its salt had to be at least an octave lower than the notes that other instruments made, harpsichords, cellos, trombones, and human singers. Indeed, one way of describing the notes employed by bass instruments is to say they are at 16-foot pitch, as opposed to the 8-foot pitch of everything else. This terminology derives from the length of organ pipe required to make deeper sounds. Here's that Jeremiah Clarke bass line at its normal 8-foot pitch. Here it is at the deeper 16-foot pitch. And here it is again at an even deeper 32-foot. And some organs have a slightly silly 64-foot. Until the late 20th century, the organ reigned supreme in the kingdom of the bass. When it was in a particularly flashy mood, it relied on the organist's feet to provide the fireworks. Such was the organ's enthusiasm for deep, underpinning bass lines that it triggered a desire to reproduce some of these effects in music that didn't take place in a church.